mixtures?
Nope.
No mixtures, otherwise.
Lava flow.
Lava flow. Other was mixtures.
Lava flow.
Two things to identify here. First, the tree. That's a whole tree. It should be the leaf.
Mistletoe.
What kind of tree is that? Cottonwood? Cottonwood?
Cottonwood.
And, the scientific name is? Number 37.
Where's mistletoe?
Just going mistletoe.
What's that?
Pupus.
Yeah, that's the one that gets cotton up on the seed. And this, was that about it? That's what you're saying, right?
Yeah, mistletoe.
Mistletoe on the top. I don't think it would. Species of Venus and species of mistletoe. So, question, we like, what type of symbiosis is this picture showing? And you say?
Parasitic.
What does the mistletoe take from the cottonwood?
Water.
Water nutrients. Does it help or hurt the cottonwood?
Hurts.
Okay.
Horse grass?
No.
Native or exotic?
Horse grass?
Annual or perennial?
Deer grass.
Where's deer grass, yeah.
Perennial. Common name, deer grass. Genus is Waldenbergia, which is number, not on here. That's one you don't need to know.
Oh, we don't need to know.
Not the genus name, just deer grass.
Deer grass.
What happened to it? How come it's not widespread anymore?
Cows ate it.
Like cow. These are the leaves of what tree? This is a tree Fresno was named after? Ash tree.
Ash tree.
No gene, no scientific name for this either. What tree is this little guy? He showed up close to person.
That's a sign of oak.
Live oak.
Live oak.
But the white on the bottom, is that right?
What's that?
Is it the one that's lighter on the bottom?
Live oak.
Oh, the leaves? Yeah, the leaves are kind of silvery on the underside.
Is there a name for it on here?
Yep. Go down to Quercus wislazinii, number 45.
Quercus wislazinii.
This one also you can tell because it branches pretty close to the ground, almost always. So it doesn't have much of a trunk. It does get acorns, edible acorns. You can grind them up, leach them and eat them. What tree is this tree?
Blue oak? The blue one of
those leaves.
Oh.
Valley oak. Scientific name?
Valley oak.
Number 44, Quercus lobata.
Is that the one with the big acorns?
Got big acorns, yep. This one had black oak, both got big acorns.
Leaves are.
This leaf, we didn't see these, but those are leaf galls on the leaves. Those are the galls we did see. Those are bark galls. What causes the galls?
Wasp larvae.
Then we'll go into wasp egg or wasp larva. And then what type of symbiotic relationship is this? It helps the wasp. It doesn't bother the oak leaf very much. So one's benefited, one is neutral. Commensalism.
Yeah, so this is an M. What is it?
What's that? Commensalism.
Oh, commensals.
Like communists, but not
really. Commensalism.
What are those things?
Balls.
How are they formed?
No one knows.
No one knew.
Nobody knows.
What?
That's the only common thing we can have. I don't know. To get it right.
Hog wallows. Nobody knows.
Looks like they think bubbles of water moving around.
Pots of water one, yeah. So there aren't very many left. So we saw these on the foothills, but originally much of the valley floor was covered with these things. But if you try to grow a crop on that land, irrigate it, and the water's not going to go where you want it to go. That's why they flatten it out.
So does it bubble up? Like is there water under those bubbles?
No, just dirt. So they think that was caused by uneven distribution of permafrost. So when the permafrost melted, the winter areas collapsed. But one idea or the other was the earthquake yellow hypothesis when it shifted inside the solar system.
Do you know how sometimes when you water lawn, when the water gets trapped under the grass, and it's a big bubble? You get water? You know that?
I've not seen that.
Oh, like sometimes the water gets trapped under the lawn, and then it creates a big bubble. And you pop it in the bubble, and you squeeze out water. But
it looks like that. It looks like water is like trapped under there.
Well, those are look like 7-8 feet wide.
Yeah, they get big. They do get big. Oh,
did you might have found out why they're there.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like that. That's the thing. And then if you leave it unattended, the ground will suck the water, and it just dries up, and it dries. And imagine flooding.
That from over irrigation?
Yeah, from over irrigation, pretty much. And then the ground itself compensates by just mixing with the water.
I've never heard that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's here on this rock, we have a sequence. We got rock, lichen, moss, grass.
Rock, lichen, moss, grass.
What is that sequence called?
Rock, lichen, moss, grass. That's the soil creation thing, right?
Soil creation, officially termed.
Soil creation.
Primary succession.
Which is the lichen?
Primary what?
What's that?
Succession.
Oh, lichen is this little patch of gray green stuff, and the black stuff is moss.
What was it? It was rock.
Rock to lichen.
Rock, lichen,
moss.
Lichen
moss,
is
grass.
Also a symbiotic organism. What kind of symbiosis is on earth within lichen?
Lichen to moss, moss to grass.
Rock to lichen.
That's not hard to do.
Moss.
Obligate mutualism.
Oh,
it's inherent, yes. Oh, my other people, I tell them, just remember it's like true love. They can't live without each other. But then on the test, it's like, I'm true love, so don't do that. But then obligate mutualism, you can't live without each other.
Obligated mutualism.
I think there's two different types of willows here, the gray ones and one in the hanging over the upper right-hand picture. Willow leaves look like this.
Willows.
Willows are a riparian indicator.
And
let's see what's on this. So we don't need to know the genus of willows. What's this one? There, the trunk. Don't look at the leaves. That's the front plant. So the stems at the front there. There are the leaves and the flowers. Not flowers don't show up very well. But dark green leaves. Serrated edges, flowers like a little cone right here.
Alder.
Another one of the riparian indicators. So we had three so far, cottonwood, willow, and alder. And I don't think we put that kind of scientific name either.
Alder. They said ash.
What's that?
Yeah, ash also.
Yeah, ash. Oh, so we had all four of them already. What's this tree?
Some Chinese stuff.
Chinese heaven tree.
Yeah. Chinese tree of heaven.
Chinese tree of heaven.
This one is exotic or native?
Exotic.
The other ones we saw, all native.
What's the, is there a
scientific name?
Chinese.
Yeah, there is, but we don't need to know.
We don't know.
So this is, those are the leaves up close and personal. So it's easy to get. For pinnate, the compound leaves, you got ash, you got Chinese tree of heaven, and later on you'll have walnut.
Yeah.
And the Chinese tree of heaven and walnut leaves look real similar, but the bark looks way different. The Chinese tree of heaven bark is smooth with really big lenticels. Walnut bark is kind of gnarly looking. Almost no visible lenticels at all. This we didn't see because it all washed away from me. This is duckweed.
Smallest
flowering plant in the world. And then floating next to it, the sort of reddish green stuff, that's azoa. That's a water fern. That we just talked about today.
Water fern.
But neither of those have scientific names. You know about, so you just know duckweed and water fern.
Duckweed and water fern for that.
Okay, this we saw, but it wasn't blooming. We just had flower buds.
Jimson.
Jimson weed.
Jimson weed.
Jimson.
Stuff that makes you go.
You know, like, but maybe it's,
no Jimson weed salt, sign to a name on this. So most of the foothill now, that first field trip, we don't have sign to a name, most of those. So this one, you don't need another sign to a name yet. I guess you don't need it whatever, because it's not on course. What's the thing about Jimson weed? Hallucinogenic, yeah, using Native Americans used it to visit the spirit world, get rid of troublemakers. What's that little plant?
That's the top.
This will go up close and personal. We already talked about that. Like, what type of a zone is this?
Preparing.
What are some good things and bad things causing the building down across the river?
Water storage for irrigation.
And one good thing is water storage for irrigation. And storing the water, it prevents flooding downstream. So that's a two for the price of one. How does it affect the riparian zone?
Destroys it.
That floods the riparian zone above the dam, narrows the riparian zone below the dam. Because without the floods, it just goes right along the narrow strip of this river itself. What about fish migration?
Stop sleeping
off the fish migration.
Okay.
What's one other good thing a dam does?
Electricity.
Makes electricity, yeah. Okay, this is trying to show you slope exposure. So remember when you're at the courthouse looking across the dam? So, opera community grows in what, the north slope or the south slope?
North slope.
This slope is facing north, this slope is facing south. If you look at the same elevation here, power conditions are going to be different on the north slope versus the south slope.
Sweater?
Cooler? Sun exposure.
Less sun, yeah. So drier, wetter, cooler, less sun. On this side, it would be the opposite. Drier, hotter, more sun.
See, the plants like the shade.
I guess around the quiz, I'd probably just ask you something like, which direction is this slope facing, and how are conditions different here compared to over here?
Oh, that's great. That's
a
good question.
So the right, just to clarify, right, the one on the right side is south? That's south?
Well, south right is now, dry. South is dry. The west is
the right side.
That's where you recorded it. You can go back to what lunch you recorded. Jason from the video says hi.
What you have to remember is the north slope has the upper community on it. The south slope has the lower.
Oh, okay, yeah. Sorry, yeah.
And that way it doesn't matter which direction I put the slide.
Wait, so it was opposite at first?
Mm-hmm. What's that?
Nothing. It was opposite at first?
Mm-hmm.
Still didn't work to say.
We got it.
We got it.
Okay, what are those holes?
Bedrock
mortars made by?
Native Americans.
Bedrock mortars.
Native Americans. Why?
To grind up acorns.
Grind up acorns because they just eat the acorn meal after they grind it up?
No, they like leach it.
And the leach the toxins. Who did that, men or women?
Women.
Good old days.
Good old days? How old?
That's supposed to be a picture of radish, but it's not a ring.
All radish.
This one, we saw one of these on Monday. Remember what this
is that
was
blue
called?
Dick?
Ethereal spear. And the scientific name of that is number 59, Fritillae alaxa. Edible bowl. Another common name for this is Wally Basket. Ethereal
spear. Six petal
bastards. The Native Americans wove bastards out of that sand. What's that one?
What, that's the blue, the baby blue something.
Baby blue eyes. Yeah.
Baby blue, yeah.
Good job.
Namahla and ZZR, number 31.
Number 31?
31, yeah.
Baby blue eyes. That's the pretty face.
Pretty face, yeah. Any guesses?
Does it rhyme with Professor Pretty Face? No.
Number 60. Fritillae ichthyoides.
60.